Hi, today we will be actually trying to recover some old computers or reuse the old hardware from these computers. So let me quickly give a background about how I got these computers. So I got a call from my friend and he said they were shifting their old office. So they have some old hardware lying around and they were just going to throw them away. So we went there and paid about 100 Indian rupees, which is like $2, and we not only got one computer, which is this one, but we got two of them for just 100 rupees. So let's try to reuse or recover both of these computers. So without any further ado, let's get started. Okay, so let's start with this one, then we will have a look at this. So let me quickly keep this aside. Okay, so now let's open the side panel and crack this thing open and see what's inside. Ouch, sorry. I hope to see a lot of dust inside. To open this kind of computer or any modern computer, you don't really need anything. You just need a Phillips head screwdriver. And as expected, there is a lot of dust. And there is a fan hanging just like this. I don't know why is this. Let me disconnect this one. And there is a lot of dust. Ouch. Lot more dust. Yuck. And the motherboard is actually a yellow in color, which means this computer is really old. Now, before I open any further or remove the motherboard and power supply and have a look at them, let's first try to boot this thing. So let me connect the mains cable, which is over here, and try to see if it works by any chance. Okay, so I can see a yellow LED just lit up on the motherboard, which is a good sign. So let me press the button. Okay, this thing did turn on. The fan is spinning and dust is right on my face. Because there is no beep code, which means this computer should work. Let me connect it to my monitor. Here is a VGA cable. And let me now switch the input of my monitor. So there is no video output, so probably the CPU is broken or the motherboard is broken. So let's do one thing, let's remove everything. First of all, let's power this thing off. I'm just removing the mains cable because I'm not really in a mood for this thing to shut it down. Okay, so let's remove everything. After taking apart all the components, I found that this computer has Intel Core 2 Duo processor, which is old but can still do basic tasks like internet surfing and Excel work. First I thought that maybe RAM was not working, so I tried to replace it and also tried reinserting in the different RAM slot, but it didn't work. Anyways, I also found two hard drives of 160 and 80 GB and a brand new power supply of 450 watts, which is a decent unit. And not the best one, but hey, it's unused and working. Since this computer had a broken motherboard, I gave up on that and tried opening the other computer instead of spending money on new motherboard, since I only paid $2 or 100 Indian rupees, so it's not a big deal even if it's not working. After analyzing this computer, I found that this one had a broken power supply. So I used the power supply from the other computer which we took apart earlier and tried to power it on. After connecting it to my monitor and powering it on using a screwdriver to short the pins, and guess what? It works surprisingly. And it said connect the boot drive. So I connected the hard drive from this computer itself, and I was greeted into the Windows XP. Okay, so we did manage to recover our PC, and this one seems to be working fine. So we have a motherboard, CPU and a cooler, and we have a hard disk. We have a couple more hard disks as well. We also have a floppy drive and a DVD drive, which are working on a parallel port, which is not anymore used. So I won't be using a floppy drive, of course, but we will use a DVD, which can be handy sometimes. And we have a power supply, which is working. So let's build a computer using these parts. Now the other computer, which I took apart earlier with the yellow motherboard, is not working for some reason. Now I will try to fix it, but if not, then we can't do anything. So let's build a computer using these parts. Once I was done building the PC, I put back the side panel and it was ready to use again. I am surprised that I was able to give this old hardware a new home. So that's pretty much it for this video guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button, share this video with your friends and subscribe for more awesome content like this, and I will see you guys in the next one.